Introducing your host, Mr. Lee Hart.
Take you back, Jason. Remember your first time fishing?
No, I don't really. Sorry, mate.
No, neither do I, really, to be honest. Yeah, it's weird, isn't it? Yeah.
I do remember, actually, on my uncle's farm, true story this, there was a giant eel that my cousin and I were trying to catch, and we were out every day trying to catch this eel for about 13 days in a row, and then my uncle actually ended up killing it with a 303. And that was my first sort of experience of fishing, so not the best.
Yeah, I'm pleased you told that story. I thought you were going to tell that one about your woodwork teacher, which is probably not suitable for this
time
kind
and
of
place,
event. But,
time and a place. Time and a place.
Yeah.
Now, there are some real outdoors characters that have been on the ITM fishing show. Men and women of the land that can teach us all some valuable skills.
The Out There Doing It nominees are Jenna Mullen, pig hunting is for girls.
How old are you, Jenna?
11.
11.
Yep, that's right. Jenna is just 11 years old and she owns and trains her own pack of pig dogs.
I can't keep up with this 11-year-old girl's teaching me how to pig hunt.
So while most kids her age are hunting Pokemon, Jenna is hunting boars and putting wild pork on the table. And what's more, she's trained some guys to grab the pig and to carry them. Because it's no fun getting covered in blood and crap.
I'm all good, eh, bro? No blood on me?
Anton Evans, for Out There Groper Fishing.
He's not a bad groper. You beauty.
This is a proper one, mate.
It's like twins. It's twins. Anton. Anton. Oh, you know, it's this one. This one's Anton. That one's Anton. Yeah, I just couldn't tell there for a minute.
Sean Mullen, for the ultimate pig dog. Sean is a renowned pig dog trainer, and we're about to reveal the secret behind his most successful pig dog breed.
They can't hold it! Release the choker!
We got the choker coming in!
How a choker works is it gets swallowed by the boar and in fact gets choked. The dog actually gets stuck in the throat. It's a special blend of Shih Tzu and Bichon. And all shall be revealed because she's done an amazing job. Right, come on, Crusher. Here we go. Oh. Good girl, Crusher. Good girl, good job. There it is. The world's first look at the new breed of pig dog, the choker. Don't get too close. She'll take you out.
Matt Watson, who would rather be fishing.
Right, well, somehow I always knew that if we got a decent boar, I was going to be carrying it.
They're going the wrong way.
I can feel those pig lice starting to get me.
So what took you so long?
I was thinking about how much better fishing is than hunting.
just got to go up here.
Yeah, okay.
You can do it.
Yeah, sure. Okay, one, two, three, go. Oh, it didn't quite make it. I can feel all of them. They're all down my back. Pig lice crawling all through my head. Yet another reason why fishing's so awesome. That and all the blood that's run down my back and ended up in my... Oh, I can't say, really. It's not nice, anyway.
Out there doing it with hunting and fishing.
And the winner is Anton Evans. Anton is not only a great fisherman, but also a highly skilled deer hunter. And here, Anton teaches us that we should remove the cover off the scope before aiming at a stag.
Thank you.
hunting and fishing, Trent, the boys, head office, and Matt, everything you've done for us. Bloody awesome. Thanks, guys. Out there doing it.
Thanks, ladies and gentlemen.
Take you back a bit, actually, Jace. We've done a lot of fishing together all over the place. I remember, I think we were on the Hen and Chicken Islands, I believe, doing a bit of long lining.
No, I think that you're thinking of Rangitoto.
Perhaps, but I do recall, I think you shorts, you had no liner in them. And I think we were long lining. I think it was off the Hen and Chicken Islands. And
no, I know what you're thinking of. I know what you're thinking of. It was definitely Rangitoto off the skiff.
Well, anyway, I think a hook ended up, you know, hooked into your testicle from that. And I'm pretty sure it was off the Hen and Chicken Islands, to be honest.
Yeah, I remember it pretty well, to be fair, and I think you'll find it was Rangitoto.
Well, I think you've got a 3.5-inch hook in your testicle. It doesn't really matter where it happened, but it did happen.
Moving right along.